Yeah.
Thomas, it's Farrell. Running from the Bureau will do no good. You know we'll find you eventually. Look, I understand. The caseload became too much. You weren't solving cases like you used to. You're talented, high-strung. You snapped. It happens sometimes.
Look, I did not snap. Someone else killed those policemen. It looks like it might have been the matchmaker.
With your gun? That seems unlikely, doesn't it? We have psychiatric staff that can help you sort things out.
With all due respect, I don't need a shrink. Look, Farrell.
This isn't Farrell. It's Malcolm Van Horn. Has your boss been bothering you?
Yes.
To be expected. They're not going to let this drop. You must continue with your investigation. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes. I mean, no. What do you want from me, Malcolm? What's going on?
Going on? You're being investigated by the FBI for the murder of two police officers. That's what's going on. You will be tested, Thomas. Of that you can be sure. I must go.
All right, everybody, welcome back to Condemned. We're picking up where we left off. We are now in... looks to be an old store, so... If you love mannequins, this is the episode for you. I wonder if I can hit that mannequin from all the way down here. Can I? A little to the right. Let's see if we can hit it. Alright, we were able to hit it. Nice. Alright, let's see. Ooh. What's going on down here? That was a pretty good throw for that to leave that man sitting there with the sign facing the right direction. Oh! No shadow, no noise, you distracted me. Piece of shit. To a happy place. Look like from the clues that we found is that the matchmaker, the object, is or has been here. Now, from what we're gathering, that guy looks an awful lot like I do. What we've put together he's using now this may or may not be the guy that we're chasing. But, the guy that we're chasing, the matchmaker, got his mannequins from in here. Oh, Cassandra. So, with the guy that we're chasing, it would seem that he also has a connection to here. Which making it seem like he is the matchmaker. I like how they tried to make it seem like the mannequins are moving. I really like that idea. Sawed off shotgun. Two shots in it. I will be back for you in a second. Shotgun. got here? I got a...
Image received. Right-handed print, missing the right index finger. This matches what we got from the crime scene. I processed all the prints. And Thomas, the print you got from the tape recorder at the metro station isn't on this hand.
I don't get it. What does that mean?
I'm not sure. I'm just saying that the print from the tape recorder wasn't made by the same hand.
So, somebody killed the matchmaker? Still telling me to use my wise. What else we got? Somebody just whispered, "I'm dead," in my ear. Put the laser away now. You're not. How do we turn this off? There's the button. Hi. Back to what I was doing before you decided to be so f***ing rude. blocked. Didn't even know you were there. Which would have been awesome, except I watched you go there. Douche. You guys got knocked over, which means if I go back this way. Avenge your kind. Can't beat people with a candy cane? It's just a fucking wall thing. I gotta give them credit. The way that they're going about trying to kill you is actually kind of interesting. As you pass them, they're following you and then acting like mannequins. That's interesting. That's really, I like that. Hey, we're gonna pick you after all. Best run. Alright, I guess we have to go back? Are they forcing, yeah, I think they're making me backtrack. Okay. It was to find a route to ground floor, continue search. Makes sense for these guys here because they knew I would have to backtrack. Sorry I took your arm, I'm gonna use this to avenge your kind. What was that? Oh no. There's a speed and block on it. Store closed down around Christmas? like after Christmas decorations are up and stuff, like that's yeah, I don't know about that. It's like their best time of year. Like I think even as a bank you would be like, hey, let them have their season because they owe us money. Okay, so this way is out. So am I out of direction to go? Hello? If you could just point me in the right direction, I'd... Oh, hi. Thank you. I guess somebody was frustrated enough to throw a box at me. Ooh. That's not nice. Somebody could have gotten hurt. Open over here, anybody? Now you have a gun too. Shoot your eye out. Alright, so we're looking to try to find Where the hell this body got dragged to? So, let's find out. Gonna go around, it looks like. Ooh. So that's down where I was. So then this, if I'm not mistaken, will lead over the area. Somebody's hyping himself up. Ooh. Hi guys, I promise I'm working on that avenging thing. Get the f*** away from me. You creepy f***ing mannequins. Okay, thanks. Bye, guys. Oh, well, that's not terrifying at all. Oh, you're still doing it. That's good. We're jumping down. I'm not playing around with the mannequins. Yeah, I think it's pretty safe to assume he went this way. Maybe we can gather that real quick if you want to be sure. Yeah, he went that way. What the f***?
Referencing. The footprint is an exact match to the print I found in the metro station car. It may be the matchmaker, but I'm still concerned about that rogue fingerprint from the tape recorder. Keep following the trail. It may lead to answers. Maybe even a body.
I would if I could, but this part of the department store is flooded. His trail ends here.
It might be a long shot, but try using your gas spectrometer. Dead bodies start decaying immediately, producing hydrogen sulfide and traces of methane. If there's a body, you should be able to sniff it out. The air sample contains usual city pollutants and high concentrations of mold spores, and here we go. Methane. It's relatively weak, but definitely there.
I feel like, even for an FBI agent, I have killed a ridiculously large amount of homeless people.
Ah!
It is right back to where we were originally. Gotta get this way then. Explore the entire basement. Lord out all of the homeless and corrupted types. Goes down here, but this area is something else. So this just brought us right back around. Really? Alright. Alright, clearly whatever the hell's going on is right around the corner. Blood.
Image received. Well, what do we have here? A matchmaker scene. But it's not quite right. It looks like you have a male corpse and a female mannequin. Exactly the opposite of normal. Well, not normal. Thomas, photograph the victim's face.
Well, that ain't creepy at all.
Shape and color of the facial mark is consistent with the painted marks on all the male mannequins at previous matchmaker crime scenes. But this is strange. Thomas, get a shot of his right hand, will you?
His right hand's missing a finger.
This guy's the matchmaker. Well, he certainly didn't kill himself and set it up this way.
See what else you can find. Too early to call. Small particles that show up as a potential organophosphate pesticide. I'll work more on that and see what we get.
We know you're in here. Give yourself up!
Backup. That wasn't done. Is there anything else in here? Okay, so the matchmaker, the guy that we were investigating initially, is dead. It looks like a copycat?
I think I've got something, Thomas. The newspaper clippings you found in the room at the metro station. Each of the articles talks about a serial killer. A serial killer that was on your case list. 9 names were mentioned. Of those, 7 of the 9 were crossed out in each of the clippings by a black felt tip marker. The only names that weren't crossed out were the matchmaker and the torturer. Of the names that were crossed out, all those cases have gone cold.
And now you can cross off the matchmaker. Wait, are you implying that there's someone stalking serial killers? So what, he goes around killing killers, and then he marks off their name in his little personal diary?
Sounds ridiculous, doesn't it?
It does, but it adds up. It almost makes sense. Hold on. Ah, shit. Wilson, I have to call you back.
Ugh.
feel like I just fell through the floor. Okay. That is where we're going to leave this episode. Thank you guys again for joining me. Now we are looking for a serial killer that's killing serial killers. We're getting very Dexter-esque. So I will see you guys next time. Bye.